everybody, ChristopherOdd here, and welcome back to XCOM 2. We've taken some injuries in the last mission, which is really going to hurt us trying to take down this black site. We've got 9 hours to go on the Avatar Project Progress, so it's time to strike. And we're taking out Zeprinic, Aeneas, Loxley, Andromeda, Looch, and Dumitrescu with a couple of flashbangs, Mimic Beacon, grenades, and just in case, a medkit. Here we go. We've also, I should say, we invested a little bit in Looch. We gave him an advanced perception PCS chip, which gives him +8 aim. And because he's got rapid fire, I've given him a repeater, an advanced repeater, which is 10% chance of an instant kill, regardless of the enemy. And the nice little combination there is that he's gonna have rapid fire, which is gonna give 2 chances to use the repeater with the advanced aim. So he's only getting a kind of negation of -7 because of rapid fire now of his against his base stats, of course.
Our contacts in the local,
so basically his rapid fire penalty is less than it was before, and there's a chance he instantly kills enemies with each of those shots.
Heads up, expect heavy opposition.
So this is going to be Operation Warhawk. Thank you, Bradford, for the motivational speech. Dumitrescu is totally ready. Zeprinic may be a little bit cautious, but I understand that. He's new. I'm going to try and take good care of you, man. If for no other reason than you're carrying our Mimic Beacon. Which we should totally have more of by now.
Infiltrate and investigate the area. Expect heavy resistance. Neutralize all hostile contacts.
Okay, so we need to investigate the site, and then we need to evacuate behind it. That's good.
We're operating in the shadows.
That's good. All right. I already hear something. If you pay close attention, you can hear mechs, or mechs, turrets. I think it's right here. Yeah, I'm thinking it's like right there. Okay. Let's see, where is Aeneas? Let's move you up here for now.
Confirmed.
Nothing so far. Let's keep going. Yep, there's the turret we saw and heard. We've got some sectoids. I actually feel like we should open fire on these things, but it makes a little bit of sense to just try and at least set up a decent ambush. Let's bring Tom in. Let's bring Loxley in here. We could bring... What's seeing this? Is this the, must be the turret. Let's bring Looch up. Bring Zeprinic up. And Tutor. In you go.
Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Oh, they're leaving. Well, that sucks. We can still see one. I mean, as long as we're not in range of the turret, which it seems we're not, like we can't see it. This is actually not a bad option. Pull one wave or one group instead of potentially multiple that we'll run into if we keep chasing. So I think we're gonna take this.
Overwatch.
Eyes on the prize.
We should definitely keep at least one. We'll keep Nemades or Nemades available to us. Aeneas doesn't matter because he's going to stay in concealment, so I'm not going to do anything with him. And then Zeprinic, let's overwatch you. And let's go. Nice. Right in the spinal cord. Come at us. Yeah, there we go. Oh, nice. Okay. Oh! Looked like it missed, but that's good. That's good, boys. That's good. Come on, clean. Clean it. Clean it. Yes. Wow.
Good riddance.
This is encouraging. Squad is feeling good. Very good. Shall I keep exploring? I think I should.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Let's bring Aeneas down just a bit.
Advent has expanded their rail network to touch every city center they've built. And this looks like the end of the line, at least for this area.
All right.
Roger that.
So because of the way this turret's positioned, he actually doesn't have any sight along this, this catwalk, thankfully.
Covering now.
I hear things walking. On metal, so they could be up here. I love the fact that we can kind of use, like, the environmental sounds to try and get an idea of where the enemies may be.
Closing on target position now.
Oh man, there's something over there. You can hear it. I'm gonna tuck in Aeneas right up here.
Hold on, are those...
bodies. The containers, the trains. This entire facility. The aliens are still abducting people. From the looks of it, they may never have stopped after the invasion.
Oh, yeah.
Those containers look like they have self-contained power cells. It could be some kind of stasis system. It's possible at least some of those people might still be alive.
It'd be cool if you could, like, rescue some of them. But we also, there's a glimpse, there's something down there. I'm not 100% sure on what it was, but there's something. I wonder... I kind of feel like I should try and kill this turret, which would give us access to this whole upper area. And the way that we would do that is just come up here with Andromeda, take the shot with Loxley, and then come back down, kind of thing. That's what I'm thinking.
Tired of waiting around.
Oh, look at this. Did we trigger that too? I'm hoping we didn't. So it's a mech down there. No, we didn't trigger it. Oh, beautiful. Okay, Loxley. This thing has 5 friggin' armor. So that's kind of annoying. But
that armor's tough.
Finally.
We will certainly try and take advantage of it. Now before we keep scouting forward, let's actually bring Tudor back here in case we decide to scope out that side. We'll bring Luch up. Zeprinik will bring back.
Position confirmed.
And we're just gonna kind of scout with Aeneas right now. I can see the mech. He's right there. Right through the window. I think I'm gonna keep going. Uh-oh. We have another turret up top. We have another mech back here. Oh my
god. Got eyes on a hostile squad.
Mech and 2 troopers. What about the squad to the left? How come we're not seeing that yet? That's so strange that we can't see it. I could go right here. I'm going to. There it is.
Got a group of hostiles over here.
Okay, so we've got a muton, a trooper, and a mech. That gives us much more of an idea of what we're working with, and knowing that, we're gonna continue.
Here I come.
Until we destroy this turret. God, that's annoying.
Hard target, minimal damage.
I mean, Andromeda has a good chance to kill it, but...
Let's move already. Locked and loaded.
Knowing, having this, knowledge of what's out here... Okay, these guys are moving. We're gonna be tracking them with Aeneas. Uh-oh. That's kind of interesting. And even more reason to try and kill this thing. Let's bring Luch up here.
Rolling.
And we could just rapid fire this thing down. Now,
let's do this.
We're gonna come up top, and then we're gonna jump this other group here soon.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Locked and loaded. Come get some.
Moving to Overwatch. Overwatch.
And now we can follow even a little bit closer. If we want. I think we're just gonna hang out here.
Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Oh, shit. Wait, what? So there's a muton, two troopers, and a mech. That's fantastic. They seem to be interested in just cruising all over the place. But this is a great opportunity to engage, I think. I think we might be able to hit a bunch of them. But we might trigger them too. If we go here, we're certainly gonna trigger them. Here, that he can't see us, but maybe.
Moving.
Nice. So I don't think we're gonna hit all of them, but we do have the mech here. And, oh, I wish we could see the mech. We don't have any vision down there, because Loxley's back here quite a ways. So let's move her over and get her set up. Let's move Andromeda in. Luch over. Yikes. And then Zeppernik.
Heading out. Got it covered.
Overwatch.
Affirmative. Covering now.
See what they do.
Covered.
Oh, that's almost flanked. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Aeneas is surrounded right now. Okay, now I don't know where those other guys went, so... If we were going to engage, this would be the time. Now I can't see them. I mean, I guess I could just run right to the edge. And just try and deal with it. Or... Maybe the smarter play is to come out here to the trees. Stay out of vision still, theoretically. I just don't know where the mech and his buddy went. Let's see.
Confirmed.
Okay, this gives us a good angle. We can hit both. I say we go for it. We've got ways to react from all sides, depending on how they scatter. He's pissed. Understandable. Oh, nice. Loxley should have eyes here. Come on, Loxley. Yes. 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 You could kill him. Let's go, Lox. Yes! So good.
Big deal.
Okay, now. We come down here, and we kill this guy. That's the plan. He's flanked. This is a little bit far for Zeppernik. Old timer. I could go up here, but I don't know where that mech and his trooper walked off to. So I kind of want to, if we're safe here, I want to make sure that we're safe.
Order confirmed. On the move.
Overall. Yikes. Okay. It's not great. We can take 230% chances. I mean, let's go for it. Oh! All right. Well.
Nailed him.
Guess that paid off. And let's just pull Zeppernik back for now.
Affirmative, covering now.
And what I can do is pull into full cover here with John. Keep us a bit safer.
Covering now.
Reload Andromeda. And then I think our next tactic here is to try and get Loxley up.
Ready to roll.
Got it covered.
She's got to move because of death from above, which is helpful. And we don't even need to move her up. We just move her over so that she can see these vipers when we start to engage.
What's over there?
That's assuming, of course, that they're still coming towards us, which maybe they're not. Maybe they're seeing all these people die randomly around them. I'm worried now that I can't see them.
Moving on target location.
Okay, there they are. There's the mech. Or is that a second mech? Because we did see one when it cut here. We saw one way over there. Maybe what we do is we try and take out the turret up top with Loxley. Not gonna trigger them. Could take some work.
Adjusting sights.
Okay, what this will let us do though is advance these guys.
Let's move already. On the move.
Can move in slightly.
Moving out.
And I actually think maybe instead, let's put Zeppernik down here.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Let's put Old Timer up top.
Got it.
Okay, they're moving out. We're gonna need a reload soon on Loxley. Let's keep going for this turret with her. I mean, one of these has to hit. We hit a 30% earlier, we can't hit 60s. So, that's life, I suppose. And now we've lost vision of the turret.
Heading there, Nye.
Let's keep moving in.
Roger that.
Nothing yet. So there's a mech. I mean, they couldn't have come this far over here. We'd spot them if they came this way, so...
Headed there now.
Let's bring Luch in. Zeppernick up.
Closing Maid's in.
And let's bring him in as well. Tommy Diddly Tom Tom.
Overwatch.
Come get some.
Affirmative. Covering lining.
Oh, shit. We might have action here. Yep. I felt it. I feel like Luch used up all of his luck on nailing that first rapid fire. It's one group, though, so that's not too bad. And we've missed both of our overwatches so far. That's great.
That is not
a good start. Loxley's not going to have a shot because she needs to reload. That's not great news.
Ready to rock.
Let's start bringing her a little bit in. A little bit closer, I should say. Let's see what our hacking chance is here of this mech. We have the ability to reload and use some rapid fire shots on him. So that's probably the right plan. But let's check this out anyway. Okay, so we can temporarily stun him, 74% chance, take control of 37, which is, I mean, it's possible. I think we'll use the stun as like a last-ditch effort if we can't clean up his buddies. But let's see what we can do here with Tudor. .50 and .50. We could use another grenade. I feel like if we're gonna do that though, we gotta use it with Tom. I don't have a good way of flanking these guys. You would think that he'd be flanked. Not quite. If I move in here though with Tom, he's definitely flanked. But even still, like, can I kill him? Not really. I mean, we could kill him with John. That's for sure. We could reconceal. Nicholas, do you have any shots? It's not looking like... Not looking so hot. I guess we could go in here. But if we do that, we have to kill this guy. Because otherwise he could come and flank either group. And is this going to give us... I'm hoping that this doesn't bring us too close to the turret. Okay. I mean, I kind of feel like we got to take the flank. We could use the grenade. I could try and use Zeppernick here. It's going to be a low percentage. But if I don't, there's not like he's going to be doing much anyways, and I'm not going to use the Mimic Beacon this early. Yeah, okay. We've hit worse!
Come on, focus.
And on this mission... Do we want to break concealment? 90% to crit. I mean, I got to imagine that that's going to just ruin his day. Then we could grenade these two. Old timer could probably take out the mech or maybe even the guy in the back. And the maids could probably clean up the mech. I feel like that's probably our best play. Come on. There it is.
Only the best. I'm spotted.
Let's get the reload going.
Oh yeah!
So let's see. If we just take a regular shot here, do we want to leave maybe one trooper, hoping that he takes off? Instead of wasting a grenade? It's not a waste, but I mean... Yeah, let's do this. Okay, that's a great start.
Draining ammo fast!
We just need one of these to hit. 272% shots, right? Right, Looch? Oh, actually, the other thing is, combat protocol does a shitload of damage because we have an upgraded gremlin. And that's something as well that can help us, and that bypasses shields, I do believe. I don't know that we need to use that now, we can just use rapid fire. Or we can take two. Nah, let's go here. There we go. Sounds like he's dropped something as well.
Oh, would you look at that?
And we can take the shot. Or we could overwatch. If we overwatch, though, he's more than likely, he's more likely to shoot back. But we have full cover on everybody. And the overwatch would stop him from running to flank. I don't think he could flank. It may stop him from running, period, which I kind of don't want. I don't mind. If we do hit him, great. If we don't, if he runs off to his buddies, that's fine. Sounds like, yeah, we hit him. Okay. There we go. Let's see what he does. Oh, he's coming in. Ballsy. Oh, shit. That's not good, though. That part, that's not good. All right. Let's rapid fire 50s. I mean, Looch is hitting everything right now. I gotta say, that's pretty amazing. I think I'm gonna go ahead and grab this.
Absolutely.
Seems like we're okay, and now I could reconceal. Advanced repeater, nice. We have a whole bunch of these.
I've got the package.
They won't see a thing.
Okay.
Okay.
I feel like when we're concealed, like, I have to kind of, like, I have to talk quieter, like they do. Let's bring Loxley up top.
Moving out.
Let's take a turn just to reload.
Reloaded. Let's rock.
Back
on Overwatch.
Now we had those three Vipers at one point that I don't know where they've gone, actually.
Moving.
Let's see if we can't get any eyes here. Oh. Oh shit. I did not expect that. Okay, so they're over there somewhere. Which means that we need to be ready for this. Should we move up?
It's killing time!
Sing Dumitrescu back.
Finally!
We'll move up ever so slightly.
Order's confirmed. Moving out. Scanning.
On Overwatch.
I'm on it.
We have, we do have the one med kit on Looch, but we can't send it out. His gremlin doesn't quite work like that. So, we could go for the heal. But being that there's so many Vipers out, I think it makes sense that we just hold on to it for a second. And potentially deal with, like, some poison or something.
I'm on it.
Which is a very real possibility. Okay.
Position confirmed.
Is he? No, is he really alone? What? I don't believe it. I really don't believe he's alone out there. But I guess it's possible. I'm gonna run Loxley way out here to the left.
Moving to designated coordinates.
I really don't see how he's alone.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Come get some.
Scanning.
Got it covered.
On Overwatch.
Scanning.
Oh, now he's moving. Oh, shit. He is not alone. Nice shot, Looch. Wow, dude. Wow, nice shots, guys. I'm pumped with this team right now. Oh, he's gonna get revealed. That's gonna suck. There's one down. Yep.
I've been spotted.
How many is that now?
Okay, so there goes our concealment for the mission. Didn't really see that coming, tell you that much. Okay. Let's bring... He's still gonna have cover, isn't he? Not really a whole lot I can do about that.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Okay, so that, I'm pretty comfortable that we're gonna get that kill. I'm pretty comfortable that we're gonna get this kill. Unless, of course, something goes horribly wrong. Which is completely plausible. Nope. Okay.
By the numbers.
There we go. Okay, honestly, Looch is... He is becoming a force to be reckoned with.
Let's do this.
Rolling.
Now, concealment is gone, so advanced scouting is out of the question.
Overwatch.
I should have reloaded Tommy here, but that's okay. So who's gonna be the brave one? Well, Tom, or Nick, I think that's what you signed up for, pal.
I'm on the move.
All right, I'll go.
Heading out.
Looks like we got a little promotion on Aeneas here. Oh shit, what's that?
I've got eyes on an advent position.
Oh no! That's really bad. It's really bad. And they've come to low ground, which is even worse. Okay. How are we gonna fix this problem? See, the mech He's got this thing called a rocket, which could kill us. Easily. I think our best bet may be to just run.
So many victims processed with such brutal efficiency. Test subjects for some sort of weapon, perhaps.
Looks more like a refinery to me, Doctor.
Once we get our hands on that sample, we'll know for sure.
Okay. So now that we've dispatched of a big batch of Vipers, this might be a good opportunity for us to,
headed there now.
To use the med kit.
Got it.
I'm just gonna try and get out of sight with as many people as I can.
Roger that!
Nemades? I don't know. I'm hoping that back here is gonna be okay.
Hope it's worth
okay.
It.
He's gonna come hunting for sure. That's a dash if I ever saw one, though. That is something I was worried about. Whoa, I don't even know how he sees him. And this guy dashed out here too, right? Shit, we almost lost Aeneas there. How did he see him, though? That's really weird. He must have... I guess... I mean, if I can see him, let's see. I guess it's just because he's around this corner type of thing. All right. But that was good. That worked out for sure. That was a totally the right thing to do in that scenario. Okay, so Luch would have a couple of shots from this
location
here. And they're good shots. The mech is a big-ass target, right? And if we can kill him, then I feel pretty good about killing everything else with our Rangers. Not bad.
Armor still holding.
Yeah, that's the only downside is his armor. It is a little bit of a pain in the ass. So here's the plan. I'm gonna come up here with Tom. I'm gonna hopefully shred him. We've got decent shots with Robert. Hopefully one of them hits and he dies. Zeprinit can come in here and hopefully kill this guy because he's right on top of him. Nemades, he's got our kind of grenade shot, which is our backup scenario in case everything goes wrong. Loxley, let's see your shots. Loxley has 100% of the guy in the back there, which kills him. So I should probably just take that shot, but let's see. And then Pius, that's kind of my plan with you, is to kill this guy once everybody else is cleared out. So, Tom. The question is... can you kill this thing? And by kill, I just mean shred. No pressure. Yep, that sounds good.
Deflection! Burning through ammo fast!
We need one of these to hit. Come on, Luch. I've been pumping you up all mission. Oh, fuck. Of course it doesn't. But that's okay. We've got Loxley. Who's 100% to hit him. And actually, you know what? We might even be better off using John to kill him. Let's bring Zepernick. Oh, fuck me. Did that just happen? Mmm. Okay. Shake it off. Shake it off. That was a bit of a misclick, if I ever saw one.
Let's bring Tudor in.
Come on. There we go.
Kill confirmed.
Now let's get this one with Loxley.
One down, thousands to go.
And
not
then, let's not misclick this one. Let's put this guy to sleep. Okay.
That's how it's done.
Keep it up, team. Now it says he earned a promotion, but he had it before. It's okay, he must have been like right on the cuff. Oh, hello. If that would have happened one turn earlier, that would have been way worse.
Hostiles coming in from the sides.
Okay, well. I mean, Loxley's definitely taking this shot. 40% to crit. Come on, baby. Oh, so close. So close. It's too bad that Luge can't see that guy. Because he's really close. Some reason we can't send the Gremlin out either. You don't always have to be in range, but the Gremlin could be really good here. It deals a shitload of damage. It'll deal 7 to 8 damage to him bypassing his shields, right? So if that works out, we could... We can't hit both. This guy's easily flanked by a lot of our soldiers. So then it just becomes about killing that mech. Which we can start with the protocol. Yeah, I think we need to go for the protocol here for sure.
I'm on the move.
Zap away, Wally. Let's go. Really wish we could name these things. There we go. So it does 4 and then like the bonus damage because it's robotic, so. Now.
On the move.
Let's bring Tudor up a bit. Come on, Tudor, buddy. Let's go. You're born for this. Nice shot.
Hostiles pacified. Gonna need to reload soon.
And then... Come down for the flank, I think.
Here I come.
Come on, Tommy. All right. This is the fucking A squad right here. Wow.
You want some more?
What's good is that, like, we have a lot of really, really strong soldiers in the medbay right now. And, these guys are stepping up in every conceivable way. Whoa, shit. So, there was a turret up here, right? And is it still up there? Or did it... Is that be... I've kind of been wondering, but maybe because the floor was crumbling due to... I don't even know what... I think it might have gotten disabled, but... Okay, let's just get everybody a little closer.
Back in.
then we're going to move in.
Reloaded.
Oh yeah. I'm going.
Heading there now. Got it covered. Scanning. I'm on it.
And let's bring Old Timer back here to join the group. And we're gonna move inside. Loxley, come on up. She's got the Magnum gun too, right? So she can contribute, actually. She's not totally useless. I'm really tempted to use the med kit here. But like, in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, what if somebody catches fire? What if somebody gets poisoned? But then the other question is, what if he gets hit for 3 damage? You know?
Position confirmed.
That's always a tough call.
All right, I'll go.
Confirmed. On the watch. Affirmative. Covering now.
Jeez. I mean, the thing is, well, the tile's gone, so I assume he's gone. I don't plan on going up there, really. Okay, Nicholas. Put on your big boy pants and get inside. Alright. We are definitely going to be moving as a group here. No ifs, ands, or buts.
I'm going.
About it. How come I can't, what's going on here? Why can't we get in there? That's weird.
Let's do this.
We can move you in.
On my way. Come get some. Come get some. Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
Scanning.
You hear that?
Yeah, I sure do. Oh, really? Okay, guys. Can we, yep. That's better. Oh, God. That's a lot of misses. Promotion earned.
Failed to connect.
On who? Oh, God. More Vipers. Oh, we still have somebody. There it is. Goodbye, big boy.
Target neutralized.
Congrats. Well done. All right. This seems like a relatively good grenading scenario. But we do have this one flanked. Maybe we can get away without having to use it.
Roger that.
Let's rapid fire. Man, as soon as I started like pumping his tires, started underperforming. Nothing. Come on, Looch. What? Is that really happening? That's really happening. Okay, let's move in here with Tom. Let's take out everything around him. Around both of them. I like the lightning hands. I don't like that, for some reason, only one of our guys has vision of the dude, of the Viper in the back. There's one down.
There you go.
Okay, Nicholas can see him. Oh, we can see him. Okay, this is good.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Let's bring Tudor in. Pius can definitely clean this up. Feel pretty comfortable with that. Let's actually see it. 69, but if we move closer, it's going to be even better. I can bring Nicholas into this position and still have a shot. Hello.
You heard the doctor. Secure that canister.
I'm working on it. Come on, Nick. There it is, buddy. Nice shot. Welcome to the squad. Pumped.
No longer a threat.
Now, we've been meticulously moving through this black site.
I'm on it. Come get some.
We just need to secure this vial. As easy as that sounds, right?
Rock and roll.
Everybody's reloaded. Walls are down. Enemies are dead. There could be more. There could be more in the field behind. Nicholas?
Affirmative. Moving
out. Take a look.
Affirmative. Moving out.
What's over there?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Here I come.
I love that accent.
Moving to position.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Okay, Nick. Let's keep going.
Okay. Moving out. Let's do this. Closing on target position now.
Hope it's worth it.
On my way.
I mean, me too.
Got it covered. Come get
I do
some.
Think that we should get
moving
a heal
on, target location.
On Aeneas
got
here.
It covered.
Got it covered.
So I'm going to take care of that right away.
This might sting a little.
At least that way, even if somebody does burn or somebody does get poisoned, at least we're going to be ready to, we're going to have enough health to kind of deal with that. Now, I'm not seeing if this is a way up or not. I think it is.
I'm on the move.
Yes, it is. Okay, so that's good. Do we have anything up top to deal with? I wonder. Let's bring
Understood.
Tudor out here to
Moving
take a
on.
Look. Looks okay.
All right, I'll go.
Sure thing. Let's move already. Scanning. On Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
On Overwatch. Come get some.
On Overwatch.
All right. Looks like the top's going to be clear. What I'd like to do is actually position our guys on this ridge before we grab the vial.
It is clear.
So we're going to start moving towards that area.
Here I come.
And who's going to be the lucky person that grabs this thing? I think we need Luch's rapid fire in case things go crazy. I think it's going to be the Rook. I think we're going to put Nick over here.
Confirmed. On the move. Moving to Overwatch.
Come on,
covering now.
Scanning.
Scanning.
Okay, let's keep going.
On my way. Tired of waiting around. Heading there now.
I don't want to jinx anything, but I feel like things are gonna work out here.
Going. Come get some.
Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Come get some. I'm on it. Got it covered.
The only thing is, he's got the mimic beacon, and I'm kind of thinking that Maybe that's not the best bet. So you know who we're gonna grab it with? Grab it with Loxley.
Rolling. Sure thing. Let's do this. Okay. Moving to position. Heading out.
And for some reason, I can't see where I need to go. It's a bit of an issue here. I think it's probably there.
What's over there?
Yeah, we're good.
Absolutely.
Let's bring Nicholas up here.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Next turn, we go in.
Top guests are scanning. Got it covered.
Moving to Overwatch.
Okay. Take the vial. Pray to the gods that be.
That's not water in there. Shen, any readings?
No signs of radioactivity, no significant energy signatures of any kind. Whatever it is, it's safe to handle.
We've confirmed acquisition of the sample. Move to rendezvous at the extraction point.
They're bringing in reinforcements.
Well, that's a pretty good place for them to bring reinforcements, if you ask me. I almost think, you know what I should be doing? In these type of missions where you have to extract and we have to get back there, we should be blowing out this wall with grenades, like, if we have the extra ones to spare, that is.
10-4!
But, yeah, this should be kinda cool.
Affirmative. Covering now. Got it covered.
Here they come. There's one. Man, that guy is freaking elusive, though.
That is not good. Hard target. Minimal damage.
I'm actually kind of impressed that they made it out of that. Like, that's shouldn't be happening. Okay, Andromeda has a promotion. Pius has a promotion. Tudor has a promotion. Loxley could use one, honestly. Bring you up here, Loxley. You might even be able to kill both with the vial in hand. Nice shot.
Big deal.
You got this. Sleep.
Okay, so I got one.
Really? Not even excited?
Let's move already. Affirmative, moving out.
That was a really successful mission, everyone.
10-4.
So it's okay to show, like, you know, a little bit of emotion.
Let's go.
Ready to boogie.
I'm God.
Eva confirmed.
More of them coming in.
Not for us, they're not. We are long gone.
On the move.
Let's go.
Okay. Yeah? No?
I'm gone.
We've done it.
Avenger, this is Firebrand. Package is secure. All surviving XCOM operatives are secure. Firebrand returning to base.
Mission accomplished, Commander. We just hit Advent where it hurts.
Whew, we did take the wound.
This was a place no living human being was ever intended to see. Happy as I am to see it gone. Something tells me the aliens won't take this lying down.
And we were pretty meticulous, especially early on, but I think that all paid off. And yeah, we're going to have Aeneas, who's not with us for a bit. We're actually going to have a couple soldiers out for a few more days that could impact upcoming missions, but I feel really good about the squad. The only thing that we're... Not the only thing. The biggest thing I'm worried about right now is the fact that our squad feels a little bit thin. Like, if somebody does go down, that's not good. So I'm thinking about doing some extra recruitment if we can get some money our way. But there's so many things we need to work on. We need predator armor, but we need alloys and supplies for that. And yeah, so.
I'm glad to see our new recruits aren't hesitating.
Bravely wounded. Look at all the promotions, though. Shit. That's awesome. Aeneas, you did great out there, dude. You did friggin' great out there. I think we should build a Blade Ranger. I think we're gonna do, we're gonna do this. Zeppernick, go ahead and grab Blade Master. Pius, congratulations. Implacable or Blade Storm? Both are actually really good. Blade Storm's great against, like, charging stun lancers, but it really makes a lot more sense if you grab Blade Master where you're dealing the extra damage. So I'm gonna grab Implacable so that we can retreat to safer positions. Andromeda, oh, hollow targeting or heavy ordnance. Hate to say it, but we're going heavy ordnance all the way right now. Dumitrescu, let's grab suppression. All right.
Now that we've recovered the apparent product of the Blacksite facility, I imagine it will take considerable time and resources to uncover the true purpose of this substance. I will begin preparations for a complete analysis immediately, Commander.
This vial was the culmination of a laborious if gruesome alien process, which looks like it involved, like, processing humans. We can now do alien encryption. Unlike the conventional encryption methods we would typically counter with terrestrial data stores, the aliens appear to be using an advanced matrix consisting of both mechanical and biological ciphers. Combined with some form of psionic interference, the thought of uncovering the aliens' most complex designs is both intriguing and frightening in equal measure.
Having now seen the inner workings of the Blacksite facility, the outcome is perhaps even more troubling than I had expected. It is clear the aliens have undertaken a gruesome task. I will leave this matter for you to investigate, Commander.
Thank you for that responsibility.
New objective added.
The aliens are relaying a form of encryption beyond anything we've ever encountered, much less theorized. We'll have to find a means of breaking the code, but I expect it will take some time.
Okay, so, let's check the Avatar progress here. The Avatar project progress.
Having destroyed their black site, you have dealt a blow to the alien operations, Commander. But there is still no time to lose.
And so, I can't say it's going to work out like that every time, but that's an example of why you don't necessarily need to panic once the Avatar project goes to, like, maximum panic scenario. Because we got an extra, like, 22, 23 days out of that, which is a pretty significant boost, I would say. Now, we've got supplies, we've got intel. One of the things that I've always kind of toyed with is, like, because these things will eventually disappear. We did start scouting the intel, and I'm wondering if we start it, is it guaranteed to stay there? And if that's the case, then we could grab supplies, then come down and grab intel. It's a kind of risky experiment, but I think it's worth just testing, because I don't know the answer. Supplies is not a huge amount either, and the intel is probably better, but it's only one way of finding out. Hey, here's our supply drop.
Coming in for you now, Commander.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
So, Sylvia Vargas and Jonathan Wright are both available at HQ. Dark events coming, new facility coming in 4 weeks, retaliation strike coming in 3 weeks. Show of Force, where we get more enemies. Alien Infiltrator is hidden faceless. The hidden one shall remain hidden for now. Here comes the Skulljack. There it is. Now, Skulljack unlocks Skull Mining, and Skull Mining is really, really important. As if the Skulljack itself wasn't invasive enough, Tigan's conceived of a more thorough means of extracting information from Advent soldiers' chips. This new Skull Mining technique could lead to new intel gains from our enemies, and could even grant access to hidden alien facilities for the purpose of sabotage. So yet another way of handling the Avatar Project progress. I can also upgrade our Skulljacks to significantly enhance the hacking capability of any soldier carrying one. So, we definitely want Skull Mining, and we want Skull Mining, like, now. So, let's make sure that the Proving Ground is always running. And I will even put, one of our engineers in here. To speed things up just a bit. So, we've unlocked a lot. We've unlocked a lot back here. Skulljack is great. I actually don't know about this either, but one consideration that we might make is to build another Proving Ground and see if we can get two things going at one time to really pump some of this stuff out. That's kind of a nice to have. I don't feel totally confident that that's the right thing to do. But I am going to grab Skull Mining. That's going to open up a lot of possibilities and really help us when we use the Skulljack. And then we'll start just pumping out exosuits and spider suits and all sorts of cool things.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
Thanks. Appreciate that. So power relay's coming. Resistance comms is fine. We still have this space here. I'm hoping soon that we can build, like, or that we can research psionics and then build a Psylab. I'm thinking maybe a workshop should go here. It's definitely going to go here or here regardless, so second or third row. But the nice thing is we get basically free one extra engineer. Actually, that's not even true. We get like three. Well, no, you get one extra per engineer that you invest, because you get two gremlins per engineer. You get two to start with at the workshop, and then you can upgrade it to get more slots. An extra slot for an extra engineer, so. Polo's back.
I am sure you will find the results to
nice, look at that intel from this data cache. Wow. That's amazing. That's a lot. That is a lot of intel. That is really good. Illyrium's great because this unlocks some of our more advanced weaponry. The facility lead is nice because it gives us a facility that we can attack right away. So if the Avatar Project progress gets out of hand, we can do this in 2 days and try to counter that. But I think, as I was just saying, I think what we should actually do here is research psionics.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Okay, so we should hit these supplies.
Strategic resource located.
Not bad. Not bad. And then we should go back for this intel.
Avenger,
we're most likely going to have either Council Mission or Guerrilla Op coming up soon. Retaliation, we still have a ways to go. Hey! Or a supply raid. Also very helpful in this scenario. So let's ignore it for now. We have 184 supplies. One of the things that I really want to start doing here is I want to try out this leader training station. So it adds a station where soldiers of sergeant rank or greater can train special leadership abilities, which gives us some stuff that we can do like out on the field. And I have no clue how this works because this is the mod from the Long War Studios guys. So should we just do it? We have a lot of supplies coming up from the supply raid and then our drop. So you know what? We're doing it.
School facility upgraded.
Thanks. Train a loader with a leader with leader abilities. So soldiers of sergeant rank or greater can undergo specialized training to become a leader. They will be unavailable for combat during the training process. Except in dire emergencies, only one leader can go on a mission at a time. So that's really important. So let's proceed. Who should be our leader? I actually feel as if Aeneas should be our leader. Polo is a very good candidate as well. You know what? I think we're gonna put Polo in there. He's been like the silent leader. He's doing like he's crushing things with his grenades. He's always gonna be out on missions with us. Let's start with him. And let's see what our options are. So, get some. Once per mission, spend an action to grant all allies within command range a plus 20 bonus to critically hit, to your critical hit chance for the remainder of the turn. Wow. Collector, killing any non-human enemy. Is this Advent counting as human? Has a 50% chance to grant one intel point as long as the leader is healthy. That's interesting. So, let's say you go on a mission with 20 enemies. That could, you get 50% chance on, but the thing is, I just don't know what non-human means. That's the question that I don't get. Because aren't they all non-human? Or does it just mean like things like vipers and mechs and sectoids, things like that? Non-human enemy? Maybe that's so that you can't go on like retaliation missions and just kill civilians for intel. Maybe that's what that means. I don't know. This is like the first level, so I don't know if this isn't the biggest deal in the world, but I think we'll take get some here, which yeah. All allies within command range, a 20 plus 20 bonus to critical hit. That could be pretty cool. Let's grab it. So how long is he in there for? I'm gonna guess 10 days? 8 days. Alright, that's not bad. That's not bad. I don't want to stop him from training. Let's take a look here. We should be getting Hunter's Instinct really soon and Biggest Booms. These are both fantastic upgrades for our group. And Vulture, which we still haven't grabbed, could be good. I mean, everything's good. It's just managing the lack of income that we have, really. Okay. And then, what I'm gonna do is, before we go to the supply raid, we're just gonna check the black market really quick.
Market is open.
Credit account verified. So they want trooper corpses, stun lancers, and viper corpses, if we're interested. Oh, look at ChristopherOdd. I don't even know who that is, but that's cool. This one was bodyguard to a former high-ranking Advent official. Former is in not living anymore. That's cool. Look at these, though. Ooh, these are really good. And we just got a shitload of, we just got a shitload of intel, too. Like, these are really good items. Maybe not the stock. The stock's good, though. It's 3 damage guaranteed. The superior speed is nice, and we may never see that. I'm gonna grab this. I'm gonna grab the superior auto loader. This we could use on our snipers, I believe. And I think I'm gonna grab the laser sight, too. I'm tempted to grab the stock, but I feel like we've overspent our welcome here. Yeah. So it'd be cool to hire that guy, but I don't think we need to. Let's go ahead and sell a bunch of these corpses since they're at a premium right now. Do that. And then in the proving ground, I just want to check. Battlefield medicine. Yeah, we need two corpses to do that. So that's, we're more than fine. But what we will do is we're going to actually recruit a couple people because I feel like we're getting a bit thin. Carla Norberg is here. Carla Norberg, boom boom, the third. Previous enemy within character, debut mission November 12th, 2013, Operation Patient Knife. That's sweet. First encounter November 12th, 2013, Operation Bloody Gaze. That's really sweet.
I never got around to ask
as rookie
doctor,
Emma Boss. That's cool.
What exactly did you do before the invasion?
At one time, I was employed as a biochemist in the pharmaceutical industry, mainly researching vaccine production techniques. Because of my background, I was rounded up by Advent and put to work in one of the very first gene therapy clinics. I saw firsthand what their technology is capable of, for better or worse.
And I'd say we're lucky to have you with us.
I appreciate the sentiment.
So I think what I'm gonna do is let's just read through some of these bios. Son of the old bishop and knight, Saradami inherited his parents' will to fight. His? But it's a, well, okay, I'm not judging. Willing to stand for what is right, even against the eyes of the masses. Fierce and loyal, Saradami will put his life on the line to save friends and comrades. Oh, there it is, okay. Sometimes it's like a bit weird. Okay, Saradami, Naomi Russell. Russell worked as a PI, totally looks like a PI, in one of the largest settlements in the USA until she was put out of business by the Advent. Single-handedly slaughtered 6 jabbers. Love that. Losing her right eye in the process. For people that don't know, jabbers are what the civilians refer to the Advent as in the book that bridges the gap between Enemy Unknown and here. So it's cool that this person threw in jabbers. After healing up, she sought out XCOM in search for a way to get revenge on the Advent and the aliens. You know what? Welcome to the squad. You've done it. Let's get you training. And I'm thinking, what am I thinking? Let's check the armory. 3 grenadiers, 3 rangers, 3 sharpshooters, 3 specialists. I think getting another ranger is a good idea. They tend to be the ones that are like at the front lines, dealing with the most potential issues. So we're gonna train you as a ranger. And then on this UFO supply raid, or no, I guess it's not a UFO, but on this supply raid mission.
Setting course for Sector 10, Eastern United States.
We're gonna take out some of our lower level guys here.
Commander, we'll need to have one of our troops equip the Skulljack for use in the field if we're gonna make any progress towards our current objective.
So let's autofill. We'll take out a couple lieutenants. Take out Dumitrescu and Andromeda for grenades. Luch is like, he's becoming pretty indispensable, I gotta say. Like, it's really impressive. I'm almost tempted to just use the stock. Because even if his, shots miss, like, he's getting 2 every time, basically. And I don't think we need the autoloader for him. So you know what? Let's just give him the stock. And let's see. Corporal there. We've got a couple of rookies to work with. Let's see. Let's give you the plasma. I'm gonna give you... you're just starting out, so you're gonna get the stock. And you're gonna get a repeater. Now... I think on Looch here, I think we're gonna go Skulljack. He's got 80 hacking right now. I actually think he has a little bit more than that, that you don't see, but you see it when you are actually performing the hack. Wild we could bring. That means we wouldn't have like a seasoned ranger. I say seasoned as if we have so many. I like this status, get some training. I think we could take out two sharpshooters. This isn't bad. Yeah, let's do this. We're gonna bring out a couple flashbangs. Nora, you can carry the mimic. Never mind. Where is it? Let's make items available. Where's our mimic beacon? Oh, it's over here. Okay, he had it. Sorry, Zepernick. Gonna lay you to rest for a sec. Mimic beacon, flash. And who else were we taking? We were gonna take out this guy, wasn't it? Or was it Twitch? I think we're gonna take out our specialist. So let's do that and throw the flashbang here. I'm not gonna bring a medkit on this mission. We're just gonna go with the group that we have. Anyways, I think we're good. Sorry for the really long episode, guys. I know this is like, Jesus, almost 90 minutes. That's insane. That is not my intention. But that black site, I was pretty tedious at the beginning, which took some extra time, and then actually we got a lot done back at the base too. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you made it this far, congrats and thank you so much for just watching this long. But let's say if you made it this far, if you leave a comment at the bottom, this is just going to be the code word, and the code word is going to be Wally. W-A-L-L-E. And that's what we call our gremlins around here. So anyway, we'll see you guys next time. Whew. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.